So we got a few things to talk about this month on our New Jersey supermarket and retail news discussion. Hey there, NJRoute22.com here with another brief look at what's going on in the stores around the Northeast here, and mainly New Jersey, but you may have some of these stores in your area as well. The first thing I want to point out is for the low-carb people, that there's this brand of breads called Thin Slim Foods, and they also have other things like muffins and cakes and brownies and all sorts of stuff. We've tried them in the past. They're zero net carb, supposedly, and it's not gluten-free. They have like vital wheat gluten in there. I think that gives it the texture. We tried them a few years ago, and I think while they say they're net carbs, zero net carbs, I don't know if it's a good idea to eat these things, because you sort of want to get away from the bread, the whole concept of bread. And I don't know, maybe you might want to use it as a gateway to going bread free in general. Like what? I just don't, they're expensive. $10 for six bagels or whatever. I just think it's not a good idea to replace what was bad. It's like getting a new boyfriend or girlfriend that was sort of like your ex that you broke up with, and there was a reason you broke up with them. Anyway, that's that. The next thing I want to point out here is, this is our own pet peeve, but you know those slider food bags? I don't know what happened in the last couple of years, but they used to never break. Now every other bag breaks. So we said, screw this. We're going to go back to the old zipper bags, Ziplocs. And the best deal is at Walmart. Just pick up some of these zipper bags, and you throw them out soon enough anyway. It's not like you have long-term food storage for like the Armageddon. Just get the Walmart brand. They're the cheapest, and you'll save the most amount of money. So that's that tip. And my next set of tips, two tips here, is from the Asian food market over in, I think it's Greenbrook, I believe, or Plainfield, I'm not sure. I did a review about them recently, and that's a good little place to go. But there's something very interesting about it, and I haven't spent enough time in there yet to really get down to the nitty-gritty of everything on their shelves. Like, it's not my everyday supermarket, but there's a couple things I really like. Number one is they have the best selection of instant coffees, not like Folgers and Maxwell House. They have two particular ones that I really like a lot, and you'll forget about brewing your own coffee or K-cups or anything like that. They have one, it's called Nescafe Gold. These are like high-end instant coffees. They're a little bit expensive, but they really taste like fresh brewed high-end coffee. And my new favorite, it's actually like almost half the cost of Nescafe Gold. It's Jacobs coffee. They have two kinds. I forget the name of them, the green one and the gold one. The green one's more, it's stronger than the gold one, but I like the gold one better because it's a little bit cheaper. But that, it tastes like almost like espresso. It's really, really, really good, smooth coffee. I highly recommend it. I can't find it in any other stores. It's cheaper at the Asian food market than it is at Amazon. And the same for my next thing. My next thing, I don't eat these, I didn't buy them, but I found a 5-pound vacuum sealed bag of blanched peanuts for $7.99. And blanched peanuts are great for recipes, and you can roast them for 15 minutes in the oven, throw some salt and maybe coconut oil before you bake them. You can make your own peanuts for profoundly less than buying other peanuts. Blanched peanuts on Amazon, for comparison, are about $20 for 5 pounds. So it's a really good price over at the Asian market. And now here's a little quick tip about what I just can't stand Hollywood cross-marketing with products. Everything is now frozen. Frozen 2 or whatever. Like every damn thing has frozen on it. And here's an example of these stupid chips that you shouldn't be buying anyway have frozen on it. Your kids see these compelling eyes from the Elsa and Anna, and it just, this is why you can't bring your kids to the supermarket anymore. I mean, I want to teach them how to shop, but with all these distractions from Disney, there's even frozen bananas. The Dole put Elsa and Olaf and all these characters on bananas, which is fine, but where are they going to draw the line? It's really, really annoying. I'm sure other parents feel the same way. And lastly, I'm going to talk about this a little bit more later, but if you go to Ocean State Job Lot, they have these paper products, which I just recently tried out, Royale paper towels, like Tiger towels, and these Royale velour or velvet or whatever the hell they were called. I have no idea. Toilet paper. The paper towels are absolutely better than Bounty, and they're cheaper. So, but I'll go into it a little bit more. If you could find them at Ocean State Job Lot near you, I highly recommend you pick them up. They're a good deal. I think they're not going to be around for long. It was probably some sort of special buy they had. But better than Bounty for less money. That's it. Hit the like and subscribe. I'll see you next video.